back to my channel. Okay, so today, yeah, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a champagne bottle cake, like a bottle of champagne cake. I don't know whichever one is correct, but choose whichever one you like. Today we're going to be making like a champagne cake, and we're going to be making a moe bottle cake. Yeah, is it a moe, moet? But Ukrainians call it mayut. Okay. That aside, yes, I already made a vanilla cake that I'm going to like be torting. Yeah, okay, so what you want to do is first divide this into two, because we're going to carve this bottle out of this like square shaped cake. Yeah, and if you've not carved before, I need you to watch my how to carve a cake for beginners video. That way it's going to tell you what to do before carving, what to do while carving, and what to do when you're done carving, so you don't like carve out your cake unnecessarily, because once you cut a part of the cake, you can't glue it back, you understand? So you should watch that video first, and I'm going to put the link right up here. It says click on me. Yeah, click on that. Yes, so right now today I'm going to be showing you how to turn this into a bottle of moet and shandan. Yes, today we're going to be calling it moet and shandan, because I can't seem to decide if it's moet or mayut. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is like take the half that we cut out and try to make a bottle shape. Yeah. And then when you're trying to shave this, make sure you should shave in bits, because you can take out, yeah, you like you can join it back, but you can always cut. So when you're cutting, cut in bits. Don't try to be in a hurry, take your time. Yeah, this cake took me about 3 hours to make. So if you're doing this for the very first time and you've never maybe shaved a cake or carved a cake before, be ready to spend maybe at least 1 hour carving, just carving, not decorating or anything, just carving, because the slower you go, the more control you have over what you're cutting off of your cake. Okay, so I'm going to be putting some buttercream in order to glue the front part of the cake to the back part, because I already carved the shape of a bottle out. Yes, that's the bottom part of the bottle. Can you see like that rounded shape? Because you want the top to be rounded and the bottom to be rounded as well, kind of like a bottle. Yes, so now we're trying to carve the like the mouth that is tapering towards the cork area of the bottle. So that's what we're carving right now, and I glue that with some buttercream, and that's my Ukrainian buttercream. It's a 2-ingredient buttercream. It is very yummy, and it is very easy to make, and it is very it doesn't have like icing sugar grease like American buttercream, and it crusts really well, just like unlike Swiss meringue buttercream. So if you want that buttercream recipe, the link is right up here above. It says click on me. It takes literally like 3-5 minutes to make. Yeah. Okay, so at this point I'm trying to carve out the tip, and you want it like to taper towards the mouth, as if like towards the cork. I don't know if you guys can notice that it is like slowly looking like a bottle. And when you carve the top, make sure like it is rounded just like the bottom, so it's not just the top that is rounded. You know when you like lie a bottle on maybe a flat surface, the bottom is rounded and the top is rounded, it doesn't just like collapse and be straight down, if that makes sense. So that's what I'm trying to do right now. You want the bottom to be as rounded as the top. And one thing I noticed at this point is that that top part is kind of too high, so we are going to use our knife and reduce it. Yes, it's a little too high, because you want it to taper towards the cork, towards the mouth, which goes really low depending on the position of the bottle. And in this case, the position of the bottle, it is lying on maybe a flatter face, because so it is moving downward. I don't know if my explanation is making sense to you guys, but if it is not, I hope you can see what I'm doing and try to replicate the same thing. So that's all I'm doing right now. Okay, so once we are done, I want to put some more buttercream into this cake, because you want the people eating it to have enough cream to eat it with. So I'm going to slice it in half, yeah, and then put some buttercream in between it, in between the layers. I bring you guys the easiest way to do the most hardest things in cake decorating. So if you're looking for an easy fix, or the lazy girl's way, yeah, this is the channel for you. So like I was saying, so please subscribe to this channel and give me a thumbs up for this video. Yeah, I worked really hard on this video, and I'd like you to give me a thumbs up, please. Thank you. Okay, so like I was saying, yeah, I look for the easiest way to do stuff. So I'm not going to make the old bottle out of cake. The tip of the bottle is going to be made out of fondant, because that just makes it a lot easier. Before before we cover the entire bottle in fondant or in cream, we need to put the details on top, like on the bottle, the cork of the bottle, like the cover. Yes, it's called cork. Yeah, okay, yeah. Okay, so we're going to put all of that detail. So when you recover our cake, it will look like you can see the shape of the details we put underneath the fondant, basically. So if you check the bottle of this drink, it has this like, it has this ridge on top and at the bottom, and it has a space in between, and it's colored in gold. So we're going to make sure we do all of those things before we cover in fondant, yeah? Okay, so once we are done, we want to cover the entire cake in buttercream. Normally, I would cover this cake in whipped cream, but I wanted in, sorry, not whipped cream, in ganache, in white chocolate ganache, but I wanted to have more control over like how it's shaped and everything. So that's why we're going to be coloring it in buttercream today, because we already like cut a perfect shape, so you don't need it to like kind of help you hold that shape. Okay, so we're going to be using the same buttercream that I told you guys about earlier to cover the entire cake. And this buttercream is very easy to use, and it is so fast to make. You can make this in 2 or 3 minutes. Yes, so if you want, if you don't know where the link is, if you didn't click it earlier on, the link is in also in the description box below. It's a Ukrainian buttercream, and it is awesome, guys. It is wonderful. You should try it out. So guys, if you're a complete beginner and you've never shaped a cake before, you shouldn't just start shaping your cake. You should watch the video where I made like shaving cakes for beginners. Yeah, that in that video I told you for how long you should freeze it for, so it'll be easier for you to cut, and for how you should cut it, and what you should do before, during, and after. So it's going to make your life a lot easier. So watch that first. I'm going to put the link right up here. It says like carving for beginners. Yes. Okay. So once we are done, once every part of our cake is covered in cream, we're going to color it in this green fondant. The bottle is green, but it's a very dark shade of green. So, but this is the green I have at home, yeah? So this is what we're going to color it in today. So first things first, we're going to roll out our fondant, and then we're going to roll it in the shape of the cake we are covering. I have a video on how to roll fondant in case like you don't know how to roll fondant, or like just to make your life easier. Basically, I have a video about everything on this channel. Okay, not everything, I'm exaggerating. Okay, so now we want to roll, yeah? If you want the video to how to roll fondant, yes, I do have a video for that. The link will be in my description box, or it says click on me right here. Yeah, click on that. So it's going to take you to how you can roll fondant. For this cake, we're going to roll it in the shape of the cake. There are some cakes you should cover in batches, but for this particular one, we're going to roll it in the shape of the cake. Remember, the cake is long and kind of slim, yeah? So that's how you want to roll your fondant as well. And like I've heard like tales of how you should roll it in one direction, you shouldn't move in several directions, otherwise it won't be nice. That's not true. Roll it however is convenient for you. That's what cake decorating is about. It's about fun. It's about what's easier for you, yeah? Roll it however it's easiest for you. Okay, so we're going to pick our fondant up, and then we're going to cover it in that same direction on our cake, and then we're going to try to smoothen all around, yeah. Okay, so when you're trying to smoothen a cake of this shape, not just a regular size cake, normally if you were smoothening a regular size cake, there are smootheners they sell specifically for that, yeah. For this one, like it's not just like a regular sized cake, so shaped cake, sorry. So we're going to be smoothing with our hands a lot, yeah. And after that, we're going to be smoothing with some fondant, and I'm going to show you how to do that in a few seconds. Okay, so you want to be careful so you won't have tears, yeah. And when you want to cut out your extra fondant, what you should do is take a knife. Don't use the fondant cutter or the fondant roller, yeah. Yes, you can do this first, but make sure you leave some space. Don't cut too close to the cake, yeah. Just cut like a little bit away from the cake so you can have some extra fondant for you to play around with and for you to work with, so that like you can't see any part of your cake peeping out. Okay, so the next thing we want to do right now once we cut off is to tuck the remaining underneath your cake. So if you watch my videos a lot, yeah, if this is not the first time you're watching my video and you've watched several of these videos that I made for like custom shaped cakes, you will know how to do this. What you have to do is take your knife, a sharp knife, and then tuck whatever extra is remaining. Just cut it off with the same knife, yeah. talk and cut. Wherever it's remaining extra, just tuck and cut. And make sure when you're tucking, whatever cream touches your knife, you clean it first. Otherwise, that cream is going to transfer to other parts of your cake, and you don't want that. You want your cake to be really neat and really nice, like neatly done. That's what you want. Okay, so once you're done with this first part, you should do that carefully for the other side of the cake as well. Okay, so hope you guys noticed how I was smoothing with some fondant. So that's the best way to smoothen, not with your hands, especially when you have like an irregular shaped cake like this. Smoothen with some fondant, just keep rubbing it on. Like, the work is slow, but it will get the job done. It will be smooth, even though like it will take you a little while, like longer than if you were using the smoothener, if you were using your hands. Okay, so it is time to brush this cake. Yeah, so we're going to give it dimension. So basically what you want to do when you're brushing, if you don't know how to airbrush, yeah, and you've never airbrushed before, then you can also paint. If you don't have an airbrush, you can take a brush and a paint. It's better though if you use powdered food coloring to paint on your contour onto your cake. What we're doing right now is trying to contour the cake to give you some dimension. And that means like when you take a bottle and when you put it on maybe a table on a flat surface, what part shines through? What part is a little bit darker? Basically, what part reflects the light? That's what you're doing when you're airbrushing contours of an object. So that's what we're doing right now. So I can't really explain it in depth in this video. So if you want to learn how to airbrush cakes, I have a video for that. So I'm going to put the link right up here. It says airbrushing for beginners. So click on that. Okay, so next thing when we are done airbrushing is to cover the board, yeah. And I wanted to give it like a fabric effect, and then we're going to do this in parts because like I don't have maybe a fondant sheet to do like a really big sheet of fondant and try to cover the board at once. So I had to do this in part, and it took me a little while longer, but like it was worth it at the end. So what you want to do is do this in bits, yeah, and like just roll out small parts of white fondant and like just fold it on top of the cake. There are no like rules for this, just fold it however you like. If you want the fabric to look more squeezed together, then do that. If you want it to look more spaced, depends on how you fold it. Just fold it randomly basically, and then cut out the excess from the sides, and that's all you have to do for this one. And make sure you wet your board first though, because like I'm using the brush to like wet the board a little with some water, just with some water, or if you want to use edible glue. So see what I'm doing? There are no rules. I'm just basically like folding it and try to fill up the spaces left. So once you're done, you need to cut out the excess by the edge, and that's all. And then your cake is completely covered. And I want you to notice we colored the cake before covering the board. That way the color won't get on top of the board, yeah? Okay, so the next thing we want to do is put a black ribbon. If you like, you can take you can check for whatever bottle you're making, whatever drink, check for the picture on Google so you can know what you're doing. For this one, it has like a black ribbon that kind of like goes crisscross across in front of the bottle on the top. So that's what we're going to be doing. So right now I'm doing that. It's going to start from the bottom, and then I'm going to cut out the excess with some scissors. So that's what I'm going to be doing, and I'm trying to make it as even as possible. It wasn't even initially. And like when something is crooked, it gives me a headache. Like that's all I can see, no matter how perfect people say the cake is, like it's the crookedness I can see, and that's a problem. Okay, so once you are done with that, you want to outline. Like this particular cake had some like gold pipings on the black ribbon, yeah. So I'm going to create that with some white royal icing, and then I'm going to paint the royal icing once I'm done. And that's all she wrote. And on that green part, there's this red like kind of stamp looking thing. Yeah, I shouldn't have added that yet because I'm supposed to paint that head gold first, because in the actual picture of this bottle the head is gold, yeah. So I shouldn't have added that first. So I'm going to take out that red thing, that red like round thing from it, and then try to paint it in gold. So okay, so and the gold you want to use for this, you want it to be really pigmented, yeah, but like really really pigmented, so like the green can show underneath. You don't want to use all those very cheap ones. So if you want to buy this gold I'm using, I'm going to put the link in my description box below. Yes, it is cheap, and if you buy in bulk it's a lot easier, like $20-$100. Like buying bulk is a lot cheaper that way, or you can buy in batches too if you want. So that kind of gold is really good, and it's edible, and it doesn't like whatever it is you're painting, that thing does not show through. Like, it just coats it completely in gold, and it's always so pretty. Okay, so that's what we're going to do, and I'm going to be careful while I paint so it doesn't touch my white background. So once I'm done with that, I'm going to put the edible paint that I already printed. Yeah, so this was made on rice paper and I already printed the logo on it. I'm just going to stick on the logo on the cake, and that's all she wrote. This cake was pretty easy and it was amazing. Don't mind the way I was explaining it, it made it seem too long, but I was explaining it so that you guys can get what I'm doing in case you want to do it, so it'll be easier for you. So thank you guys, and I hope you enjoy this video because I really loved making it for you guys. Thank you, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.